Hello, everyone. This is Richard Carlton. I'm here with
Dave Henderson.
And Dave Henderson's one of RCC's senior engineers. And we're here today talking about the new release of FileMaker 13. This is pretty exciting.
Yes, it is. I'm looking forward to it.
Now, we've been working with FileMaker 13 for a while, getting everything tested and ready to go out the door on our end. And I want to take a couple moments today to explain the big business picture overview of what FileMaker 13 represents to our business customers.
I think it's going to be a vast improvement. I think everybody's going to like it.
Now, first off, we still have FileMaker Server, FileMaker Pro, and FileMaker Go, and all these have been improved.
Correct. They've all been improved.
Now, what's your favorite piece of these that's been improved?
I am really looking forward to working with the Web Direct because I think that's going to give our customers a tremendous ability to not only leverage information systems within their company, but put their brand out there in the public. The potential's huge. I think it's going to be awesome.
And that's a good point. And what Dave is describing is FileMaker's new WebDirect technology. WebDirect is the ability for FileMaker to actually reproduce FileMaker layouts that are accessible via a web browser. Now, instant web publishing has been around for a long time since FileMaker 4. And this was kind of the promise of what this should have been. Now, it never really worked very well, right?
Not as well as people would have liked.
Yeah, in fact, it really wasn't even close. And so instant web publishing has been kind of pulled out of the product and put out of its misery. And WebDirect is now in there. And this technology works really well.
It is meeting the potential that instant web publishing was intended to.
Exactly. Now, what's really important here is the positioning. WebDirect is not a replacement for FileMaker Pro. FileMaker Pro is a purpose-built database client where you actually build and design your database solutions, but then you have the full power to access and work within your database. WebDirect is a browser-based client for your database. Therefore, it does have certain limits, and those limits are placed upon it by the web browser. So for example, WebDirect cannot actually run all the different script steps that are available in the FileMaker platform. Now, it runs most of them, but it doesn't run 100% of them.
That is absolutely true. To properly leverage WebDirect, you're really going to have to give some thought as to what part of the database you want to present in a web browser and how you want to present it. You're going to have to be cognizant of the limitations. Because as you mentioned, it's not taking full-blown FileMaker and putting it out there on the web. It's going to have limitations. But that does not mean that those limitations are a hindrance to the potential of the product.
Exactly. What Dave has said here is so true. And so what we have to help people with this is a video that'll be out within the next week, which is about a 30 or 45 minute video, which is all about optimizing and tuning FileMaker layouts for use on WebDirect. And to summarize real quickly where you want to use WebDirect is outside users of your FileMaker system, maybe like a third party vendor, or maybe a small outside sales team where they might have limitations in purchasing and installing FileMaker Pro. Maybe an outside vendor who doesn't want to purchase FileMaker Pro. So with only access of a browser, they can access the database and it looks and acts just like FileMaker Pro.
It's true. It's great. It's a very FileMaker-like experience on the web.
And so once again, of course, while it works and quacks a lot like FileMaker, it's not a pure replacement for FileMaker Pro. So we just have to caution our clients and our customers not to think that they can just toss FileMaker Pro out the window. They're still going to need to use Pro, but now they have a new opportunity to deploy into areas where they couldn't really deploy FileMaker into before.
Absolutely.
So that's just part of what makes 13 so special. They've gone out, they've really revved up FileMaker Go. That's that purpose-built client for the iPhone and iPad. That's greatly improved. That software now can directly scan barcodes with the Go technology straight into the database without using third-party software like a plugin.
And that is an awesome thing. I've had half a dozen clients in the last 8 months ask me about barcode technology in FileMaker.
Well, now it's built into FileMaker Go.
And it's going to make my life a lot easier.
There's all sorts of improvements to FileMaker Pro. And of course, that works Mac and Windows. And that includes all sorts of interface improvements, the ability to have things on screen hide themselves automatically if the situation warrants, the ability to have these new slide controls in addition to tab controls. There's all sorts of great new interface improvements to FileMaker 13. And of course, I don't want to get too far away from the idea that FileMaker 12 and FileMaker 13 are completely interchangeable. And I guess we should have mentioned this up front. FileMaker 13 still uses the FileMaker 12 file format.
Yes, so there's no pain and suffering from changing formats. You don't have to convert anything. It pretty much seamlessly works.
Now, keep in mind, obviously, if you use 13 specific features, the 12 people aren't going to see the new 13 features, yes. But and that makes sense, obviously.
The fact that the 13 specific features will not be experienced by FileMaker 12 users will not keep them from accessing the utility of the database. They'll still be able to get their work done. They'll still be able to see what they need to see.
And of course, one last thing that we should mention here is the new security improvements in the FileMaker platform. We always had point-to-point encryption. I guess we should explain this real quick to everyone. So as you access your database from your client to your server, say you're on Go and you're across the internet, there's a checkbox in the server that you check off that encrypts the information as it travels back and forth. That's been in 12. It's been actually in 11, I believe, for a while.
Yes.
And so that's been there. It was 128-bit encryption, which is just the level, the strength of the encryption. They've upped it to 256. But in 13, there's a brand new security feature, which is what they call encryption at rest, EAR. And that basically means that FileMaker server will be sitting there in the background encrypting the database as it sits on the hard drive of the server, which is huge, especially if you're in the medical fields with HIPAA, or if you're in the government with certain restricted database type systems. I know Lockheed Martin and some of these organizations will be very interested to know that their databases are being encrypted. That also applies to the backup copies of the database. As the server's making backups, those backup copies are actually encrypted at 256. And they're encrypted at such a level that if you forget the password, the administrator really forgets the password, they're really screwed because they cannot send the file to anyone, including FileMaker, to have the password reverse engineered and got out of the file. They are in big trouble. Understand that this new capability in 13 is specific to the times that we live in. They've upped the security another whole level, vastly improved. So we have a lot more videos coming about the FileMaker platform in general. I have a complete video on WebDirect that'll be coming out about optimization performance and knowing where to use WebDirect. And of course, we have a complete series of videos about FileMaker Go and how to build and optimize for FileMaker Go. So be looking for us to email you about those videos as well. So for now, that's Richard Carlton here.
Dave Henderson.
And that's it from Richard Carlton Consulting. Thanks.